Hey everyone, and welcome back. In this video, we are going to discuss two different ways of setting up your React Native project. The way you choose to set up your project will define how your whole application code is going to be set up forever. So this is a very important step. One way of creating your project is called Expo, and another one is called React Native CLI. And my main goal with this video is to compare these two and let you understand what are the advantages and disadvantages of using each one. So let's dive right in. Expo is a user-friendly framework built specifically for React Native. It simplifies the development process of cross-platform mobile applications. And the biggest advantage it has is that it is super easy to set up and test your applications with it. You also get a set of pre-configured components and libraries that help you quickly build your applications without having to deal with the native code and some complexities that come with it. On the other hand, we have React Native CLI, and CLI here stands for Command Line Interface. It takes more time to get set up with React Native CLI and start creating your project. And it has been a traditional way of developing React Native projects until lately. And I think the main reason why React Native documentation encourages the users to use Expo over React Native CLI is exactly the point that beginner developers have an easier time setting it up. However, the easy way does not always offer quality in the long run. And the main advantage of React Native CLI over Expo is that you have full control over your projects, including the ability to modify native code and access device-specific features directly, which is not the case for Expo. React Native CLI provides complete control over your project configuration. And this is a huge deal because it means that you can tailor your application according to yours or your company's specific requirements. The flexibility offered by React Native CLI allows for deeper customization and seamless integration with native code, ensuring you have access to all the device capabilities. This also means that you can optimize the performance of your application, integrate native libraries, and leverage advanced device features. And this level of control is particularly valuable for complex or resource-intensive applications. Expo is somewhat limited, even though many developers have created libraries that are compatible with it. On the other hand, using React Native CLI gives you access to a much broader range of libraries and pre-built code developed by others ready for you to use. This allows you to avoid reinventing the wheel, as most of the tools and features you might need are readily available when working with React Native CLI. It empowers you to improve the performance of your application. As your project scales, becomes bigger, and attracts a larger user base, performance will become very important. You wouldn't want thousands of your users to have an application that's slow or lagging. With React Native CLI, you have the granular control needed to optimize your app's performance that ensures a smooth user experience even under heavy loads. This is why I also want to talk about why big companies tend to avoid Expo and opt for React Native CLI instead. Companies often have unique requirements and strict security policies, and React Native CLI allows customizing their projects extensively and implementing specific security measures. This level of control ensures the highest standards of security and compliance, which is super important. Also, enterprise applications often handle larger data sets and perform more demanding tasks, and fine-grained control over performance becomes crucial in such scenarios. React Native CLI allows optimization at a deeper level, ensuring scalability and top-notch performance for enterprise-grade applications. Now, you might be wondering why, as an instructor, I chose React Native CLI for this course, despite the advantages Expo offers. I could have made this whole course around Expo, and we would be able to go through setup much quicker and easier. And I would have way less videos to upload and maintain. However, this decision was made with your long-term growth and career in mind. Unfortunately, when I was learning React Native CLI, I had to do it all by myself since the resources for CLI setup has been very scarce. And this course is literally the only course on Udemy that teaches you how to use React Native CLI. And I made sure to record this because of the experience I went through as a developer when initially getting started with this technology. While Expo may attract a bigger audience and offer a faster development process, I specifically chose React Native CLI to ensure that you are ready to join any company and utilize the best possibilities that React Native CLI offers. You will go through interview process smoothly with the knowledge that you're going to gain here. Moreover, if you're planning on creating your own application for your business, this should be even more important to you as when your application is going to scale to a larger audience and people start heavily using it, you would want to be ready to optimize the performance and implement complex functionalities. After completing this course, if you still want to learn Expo, I assure you it will be like a piece of cake, because the basics that you're going to gain in this course will be more than enough to tackle Expo project. However, I really doubt that once you have experienced the power and flexibility of React Native CLI and you already know how to set it up, you would ever want to go back to Expo. So I'm very excited to have the opportunity to share this knowledge with you. Thank you so much for watching and choosing this course. I can't wait to get started with you in the next set of videos.